So apparently it's my thing to call out problematic men on TikTok, and I'm here for it. Let's talk about this guy and a couple videos that he made that really messed with me. He made this trash video where he intentionally went and flirted with Jasmine when he had no business doing so. He literally did it to make money and make content for the internet. This performer had to deal with his harassment and have her face put all over the internet looking awkward and uncomfortable. This is akin to going up to a woman in a nightclub and hitting on them and filming their reaction. Not okay, coach. I am not the first person to call this guy out. Sean in Orlando here, he called him out a couple weeks ago. I tried to stitch the video, it is too long. I tried to download it, it looked terrible when I tried to upload it. Not his fault, my fault. But go follow Sean. I've said it once and I will say it again. Performers are not there for you to make content and make money off of. Talk to them, video your interactions, but do not try to get a reaction out of them for content. So I had to pull over to answer this one. This person actually doesn't agree with me, but they're kind of proving my point. JoJo knows that he shouldn't be making this content. Whether he knows the performer or not has nothing to do with it. Somebody's gonna see that video and be encouraged to do the same thing. But believe you me, they are going to ask something way more explicit. Friendship has nothing to do with what I was saying. Being friends with a performer doesn't mean you get to use them for content. Also, people watching it on TikTok don't always realize that. So JoJo knows it's wrong, knows he shouldn't be doing it, he's still doing it anyway and putting it all over TikTok. And even if that performer did consent to that one interaction, putting it on the internet is going to make life difficult for every other performer who's not consenting to it. So sorry, but your argument is trash.
I don't let trolls just troll.
This issue has come up for me recently and I have a lot to say about it. Can I just tell you, when the diss talk stans and vlogger stans get in my comments, yes, it is a gift from the heavens. Not only do I get more money every single time you comment and argue with me, but trolling the trolls as a former Disney villain, who do you think you're messing with here? I made an entire career off of trolling people in real life, not just behind a phone screen. So if you try to come for me in the comments, bless your heart and have a magical day. Let me tell you why this is super problematic and straight up creepy. This person's like equating Disney with like the human race or a religion or something. Like, that's not very Christian of you, or not very Disney of you. These are those people that treat Disney like a religion or a cult. I love Disney, but I know that they have a lot of problems and I'm going to call them out for it. I'm also going to call out vloggers who are doing things that are problematic and harmful for cast members. Notice I never say anything bad about the actual person I'm talking about. I always talk about how the content is trash or how they know better. If loving something like Disney means that I can never criticize it, then want no part of that. And if you can't take somebody's perspective who actually worked in that role and who actually knows how harmful that kind of content can be, you need to think about seeing him as a celebrity versus an actual former cast member. He's acting like a celebrity. Yeah, next.